negotiations with North Korea were never honored by Washington. Wilkerson warned given instructions on an earlier nuclear report during 2000, in which Pyongyang committed to support its nuclear weapons program in exchange for Western aid to develop civilian atomic energy. But he says the Bush administration reneged on its side of the bargain, referring to North Korea as an axis of evil. Reasonably, Pyongyang could then resort to building up its defenses with nuclear weapons. When President Trump disparaged the failures of previous President Bush and Obama administration to deal with North Korea, he was either mendacious or ignorant, probably the failure of U.S. policy in Korea is that it has deliberately never allowed diplomacy to succeed. That's because American geopolitics is fundamentally all about not just in Asia-Pacific, but in every other region of the world. It is an essential part of how U.S. capitalism functions. Now that the American military relations, and in particular, dares to defy the American global order, including the enemy of weapons and civilians. Former British Foreign Minister Malcolm Rifkind, in an article for Russia's Vladi discussion forum, asserted that there is no simple solution available to resolve this crisis. Why intelligent Russians would feel obliged to listen to the likes of Rifkind in a curious fashion? In any case, Rifkind is plain wrong. There may appear no simple solution to the mindset of people like Rifkind, who are imbued with pro-US imperialist propaganda, who unquestioningly view North Korea as a problem. But in actual fact, here is a straightforward and accurate solution to the never-ending conflict in Korea. That is for the U.S. to withdraw its military and its relentless threats of aggression towards North Korea. The U.S. needs to sit down with North Korea and other nations of the region, including China and Russia, and discuss in full the requirements for peaceful coexistence. For a start, the U.S. should be compelled to sign a decades overdue peace treaty with North Korea and to openly say that it repudiates the use of violence for its political objectives. A solution is at hand. It simply requires the U.S. to stand abiding by international law and to renounce its genocidal prerogative to destroy other people. The stronger powers in the region, Russia and China, must insist on this basic requirement. They must say clearly that all party talks should be convened immediately and that all sides must commit to peaceful settlement. No exceptions, no excuses. What is ultimately problematic, and the world will see this, is that the United States, as we know it, under its ruling system, will not and cannot abide by this situation, because it is inherently a war-mongering rogue regime which exceptionally arrogates the right to cast the shadow of annihilation on the rest of the world. What you heard were excerpts from a feature were offered by famous journalist and editor, Sirjan.